Bonjour. Have you experienced some French rudeness since you live in France and you may not always know what triggered this reaction and how to react? I am giving you my tips as a French person. This is what I do to avoid rudeness and also defend myself. These are not infallible rules, but they can help you to understand the French mentality, how to navigate the Frenchness and not to get off on the wrong foot. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. I'm Giga, a French serial expat. After navigating the culture shock in the UK, Spain, Argentina, but also Brazil and Ireland, I now help English-speaking expats to decode the French culture and also administration. If you like the video, please give it a like by clicking on the thumbs up below and also subscribe to my channel. Merci! Let's start! Tip number one. Always say bonjour. First, you want to avoid annoying the French and use the first French etiquette rule that French kids are taught by their parents. Always say bonjour before interacting with someone and in almost every situation, for example when you enter an elevator or at the doctor's waiting room full of strangers. This is something that comes naturally to most French people as it is part of our education. I know this is not considered as rude not to say bonjour in some cultures, so not saying it in France doesn't come from bad intention. But if you don't, this will be interpreted in France as a lack of respect or even a lack of education. So using every time this simple word will already be a good start if this is not already your habit. Bonjour is used for every type of interaction, professional and personal. But the one that sometimes triggers more confusion for some foreigners is to always say bonjour in the context of customer service. If you require something from someone, even if it is their job, they deserve respect. And in France, the first mark of respect is acknowledgement with a simple bonjour and eye contact. Tip number two. Do not assume that the other person will speak English or should make the effort to speak English. If you come to France and do not speak French, of course, you are not going to learn it in 2 weeks. But I strongly recommend you to learn a few words like bonjour, hello, merci, thank you, and this magical sentence. After saying bonjour, you should always ask in French if the person speaks English by saying parlez-vous anglais? Then you will be able to continue in English. This is something that annoys French people, especially in Paris, because of the large number of tourists, when people will directly speak in English without trying to pronounce a few words of the language of the country they are visiting. In the large majority of cases, saying bonjour, parlez-vous anglais will allow you to continue in English. But also make sure that you speak slowly. Keep in mind that their English may not be better than your French after all. These two tips will avoid you the most common French faux pas and start on a good note. Don't get me wrong, sometimes this is not enough. The other person may just be in a bad mood, and there are also other cultural differences that will explain why French people don't react the same way people do back home. Tip number three. The client is king belief doesn't exist in France. Customer service is not part of French culture. Yes, I promise you, I am French. Customer service is not blended into French culture the way it is in others. It is not considered an important value. And France has more a culture of boundaries than acceptance. If you want to know more about the French no man culture, check out the video up there for more insider tips. Tip number four. Be understanding and you will win them over. So now that you say bonjour, parlez-vous anglais every time and that you don't expect a client is king behavior, you are quite Frenchified in your approach to customer service. At least you assimilated the minimum skills to avoid some French rudeness. But sometimes this is not enough, and this is when you need to be strategic. I know this can be tiring when you just want the service you're paying for and that you expect to receive a specific support from a French administration, for example. But if you see that the other person is becoming irritated or annoyed, this may have nothing to do with you. My first approach would be to be nice and understanding of the possible reason the person is irritated. We would say in French, procès dans le sens du poil. That would mean to get on their good side. So for example, if the waiter arrives at your table late because it is rush hour, he's alone serving and you are making a point when he arrives that you've been waiting for a while because you're used to a faster service, there is a big chance that you will wait for your drinks for even longer. I personally don't like slow service, and this is something that really annoyed me when I came back to France after living in London, where everything goes fast. I tended to have a bad strategy by not being so understanding. Now I would be saying something like, rush hour is always stressful, right? Especially if you're on your own. Basically, say anything nice that would show that you understand the other person's situation, or at least imagine it. Even if you think that you should still have received whatever service a different way. Tip number 5. Be assertive. If all of this didn't work, and depending on the context and also what you are expecting from the other person, this is the moment to become assertive. You need to show that you know what you are talking about and that you are in your right to get what you're asking for. This is important to keep a calm tone and remain nice but firm. The nicer you speak and the more assertive you are, the less the other person will have reasons to become aggressive. Yes, because French people can definitely become aggressive. If you realize that the other person didn't know what they were doing, like a prefecture clerk telling you a wrong piece of information, and you know it should be another way because this is your third permit renewal, for example, you need to be super strategic. Do not point out how wrong the person is. The French tend to be proud. Instead, make the other person realize that they are wrong and give them a way out. Otherwise, the other person would rather turn you down than admitting the error. I am sure that if you have lived a few months in France, you have experienced some French aggressive reactions, without understanding why. In short, knowing and using the French rule of etiquette will avoid you some French rudeness or direct reaction. It is mainly a matter of cultural differences and customs. When a French person feels disrespected by someone, the French will not hesitate to make a point. I hope these 5 tips will help you to avoid some French rudeness. If you found these tips useful, please give this video a like by clicking on the thumbs up below. This will help other people to find the video. And also subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Merci et à bientôt.